Do you want to know how to add a pin it button to your blog? Do you want to know how to make your images pinnable from your website or blog? Maybe you're looking for ways to embed pins on your site so that you can increase your shares on Pinterest. So hey there, it's Nadalie Bardo, your Pinterest coach here. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can embed pins and activate that pin it button. So if you love Pinterest marketing tips, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Okay, so here's a look at what that pin it button looks like. When someone hovers over the image on your blog, maybe they're just scrolling by, it prompts them to pin it to Pinterest. So there are a few ways to do this. I'm going to show you my favorite WordPress plugin, as well as how to do it for free with the Pinterest widget builder. Have you ever heard of it? So here on my site, you can see that we've got two types of Pinterest buttons. So when I hover, you can see it says save pin for later, but we also have my sidebar share options using a social media plugin like Social Warfare or Grow Social Pro. You're able to customize this. So when someone clicks on save it to Pinterest, the image is preloaded and all they have to do is select the board they want to save this pin to. So if you want to be able to add this functionality to your site, whether that's to your blog posts or even to your product pages, it's very easy to do with a plugin like Social Warfare. And here we can see in the back end, you're able to preload social media titles, descriptions, pin titles, pin descriptions, and even custom tweets using a social sharing plugin. And this is really easy to do with WordPress. I really do recommend the Social Warfare Pro plugin. It's only $29 a year to give you access to these additional features that allow you to customize that share button and these options in the back end. And you also usually get a discount if you renew with them. So it gets slightly cheaper on the second year. Click down below if you're interested in getting Social Warfare. So once you have your social sharing plugin installed, all you have to do is then upload your image to your content. So for blog posts, because I want to get this hover over action with the button, all you have to do is add your pin image to the body of your blog post. So we can see right here, this is the image, it's been embedded, and you're able to add those details here. So that when someone is on your site, all they have to do is hover over to be able to then pin the image, okay? But this is how you do it with a paid plugin like Social Warfare. So that's how you can embed a pin image into your content, as well as turn on that pin it button, the hover over feature, and as well as the sidebar share buttons using a plugin. But there's a free way to do it. Granted, it's not as seamless as using a social sharing plugin, but you can do something similar with the Pinterest widget builder. Allow me to introduce you. To get access to the Pinterest widget builder, you can simply just Google that, or I'm going to put a link down below. Just click and you can start using it. Of course, you're going to have to log into your Pinterest account. All right, so first things is that save button. If you want to create that hover over or that save button within your content, you can do that with the widget builder. So right here, we're setting the button type. Do you want it to be for any image on your site, just a particular image, or do you want to recreate that hover over button feature? So we can see right here in the preview, you can make it round, you can make it large. So we can see right here, this is our button we're creating. So you're going to have to copy and paste this bit of code into your content where you want this button to appear. So using the widget builder, you always have to paste in a bit of code into your content for it to work, okay? And you can do this on the back end in WordPress as well as any of the site builders that you're using. Okay, you can also create one for follow. So if you want someone to follow you, you would just add in your username. You can even put your name here. And if they click this button, when you embed it into your content, they're able to follow you. Okay, so some of these widgets have two steps, and I'm gonna show you how to embed the code with the pin option. Okay, so first things first, let's add a link to a pin. So go to your Pinterest profile, and you're gonna want to navigate to a pin you want to embed in your content. So let's do this with an idea pin. I'm gonna copy just the URL to that pin back over in the widget builder. Let's just update this, okay? So here we have our pin. I'm just gonna press play. There you can see it's embedded and you can see it has the save button. You can choose the size, small, medium, or large. So obviously you're gonna wanna go with large if you want to have those larger built-in images, okay? So scroll down to the very bottom of the widget builder. You'll see that you have two codes that you need to paste into your content. So one is where you want the image to show up. So copy it, head on over to your content builder. So I'm in the back end of WordPress. This is a blog post. Where do we want this pin to appear? So I'm actually just going to add in. So we want to make sure we actually have an HTML block. So I'm just going to convert this, edit as HTML. It's a code box. I'm going to paste it in. Okay, that's part one. Go back to the widget builder. You're going to copy the second bit because you need to paste this before the closing body tag on that page of content. So that's not as complicated as it sounds. Within WordPress, and I'm sure your own content builder, whatever you're using, you can usually get access. It says scripts, we've got header and body. We want to paste it body and it says before closing body tag, which is just what we need. And you're just going to hit update, or if you want to preview it to make sure it's working. And then let's scroll down and here we have that idea pin. So I'm just going to press play and we can see the idea pin is there and that they can even interact with it. And there's also a prompt to save it. So this is kind of big. So this is how you can embed a pin within your content without using a social sharing plugin, just with Pinterest's very own widget builder. Okay, so you can do that. You can also do the same thing with any Pinterest board, or if you want to embed your Pinterest profile, it's just going to show all of your recent pins and you can just embed this bit of code just like we did with the pin. You're going to put the code where you want it to appear. And just don't forget to add the second part, which is the script. So there you have it. That's two ways that you can embed images that are pinnable in your content, how to get that pin it hover button. And you can do that for free with the widget builder. But honestly, I'm kind of partial to using a paid plugin. I just think it's easier. So if you want to start using Social Warfare Pro, be sure to click down below and you can get access to that. So if you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and be sure to subscribe to my channel because I've got content coming your way every week. And stick around, you're gonna find this video helpful. And bye for now. I'll see you in the next one.